In the Zoom web portal, from the left navigation under Admin, click to expand User Management and then click Roles. By default, you'll see three role names: Owner, Admin, and Member. The sole account owner has full privileges that can't be changed. Members have access to basic Zoom functions, but not management privileges, and those can't be modified either. But for some, there is an edit button at the end of the admin row. Owners are the only ones who can modify roles by default, so they should enable role management for admin or a custom role if they want some help managing roles on the account. Click Edit to arrive at role settings and begin customizing the admin role. Choose to allow view-only permission, so they can see the setting but not change it, enable edit to grant an admin permission to modify the setting, and for some settings, you can set the scope of the admin's control if necessary. Under the heading User and Permission Management is the ability to enable or disable admin from viewing or editing other users, groups, or contacts, as well as adding and managing roles like we're doing now. The next section is Account Management. Here you can choose which account level items admins can view or edit from Account Profile, Account Settings, Webinar Settings, and Recording Management. Unless altered, admins can enable and disable or lock features for everyone on the account. There are also subsections for billing, reporting, and other features. Some of the options for admin depend on your account type and which Zoom products you use. For example, some users will also see Dashboard, Zoom Phone, Chat, Whiteboard, Zoom Rooms, or Devices here. You can customize the same settings for group admins who are responsible for managing users and settings for a specific group. You must first have set up a group. Learn more about groups in the Zoom Learning Center. Once you have the permissions where you want them, easily elevate existing members into this role by clicking the Role Members tab to the right of the Role Settings tab. Click Add in the upper right corner and type in a member's email address. Alternatively, navigate back to Admin, User Management, Users, then click Edit next to an individual or select multiple from the list, then select Change Role. You can move members in or out of roles at any time. If you have a specific need to fill on your team, or perhaps you need someone with fewer capabilities than a typical admin but more than a member, you can create unlimited custom roles. Click back to Roles, then Add Role in the top right corner. Give the role a name and, optionally, a description. I'll call this one Billing Support because I only want to allow them to help manage my subscription. Click Add. You have all the same customizable permission choices in this view. However, custom roles start from scratch, unlike we did before with Admin. This is designed to give you maximum flexibility. For my purpose, I'll click on the Billing subsection and check both View and Edit boxes in both of the available rows. Click Save Changes when you're finished. Just like before, you can add members to this role by clicking Role Members and then Add to input their email address. You can edit this and any other custom role at any time by clicking Edit from within the roles list. And if your needs change, you can delete any custom role. When deleted, any users assigned that role will then be changed to the member role. Well, I hope I've fulfilled my role to help you learn how to set them up. Talk to you later.